Hey, all you world history buffs out there. It's me, Captain America. It's a quick secret. It's really Mr. Yarbrough. Here to give you a quick rundown of Mr. Yarbrough's world history class. Now, today we're going to be talking about the storming of the Bastille. Yes, I got my trusty sidekick here, DC Comics. Superman is also on the way to help us out. Now, let's talk about the storming of the Bastille during the French Revolution. First thing we need to know about the storming of the Bastille is that the Bastille was actually just a prison. It was a maximum security prison against people that were political influences, could cause overthrows of the current government. There was only 7 prisoners there at the time. But one thing that was kept there was a massive amount of gunpowder. Now, why do we need gunpowder? We need gunpowder to make guns work. During this time, there was about the Third Estate, they were upset. They just met with the tennis court note, the first start to this thing known as the French Revolution. It's called the Storming of the Bastille. Remember, the Third Estate, they're upset, so they storm the Bastille. There's about 1,000 guys that all come from all over with their shovels, pitchforks. Now, previously, they had gotten some muskets, some guns, but they didn't have any gunpowder. Once they get to the Bastille, they ask Governor Launay, they ask him, they say, look, we know that you have a lot of gunpowder there. Will you give us some? Will you give it to us? Launay refuses to. So because of that, the Third Estate, they continue to get more and more hostile. Next thing you know, guards of the Bastille open fire on the thousand people from the Third Estate who are storming the Bastille. They go into the Bastille, they take it, they steal the gunpowder, they release the prisoners. But then they also take Governor Launay's head, chop it off, put it on a spike, and start marching it through the streets in Paris. The day the storming of the Bastille took place was on July 14, 1789. Now, France still celebrates this day as National Celebration Day. This is almost like France's 4th of July for them. Because like I said, this starts the French Revolution. This is really what starts it. Now, not long after this, France also, that Third Estate, the National Assembly drafts this thing that we like to call the Declaration of the Rights of Man and Citizen. Now, it's very similar to what we see in our own American Constitution, but there are some differences. Yes, it does have a preamble in it, but it has 17 articles. Remember, our American Constitution only has 7 articles, plus amendments. But the Declaration of the Rights of Man and Citizen has 17 complete articles. Now remember, this is the outlines to how this Third Estate wanted the government structured. I hope you enjoyed this quick rundown. I know it was short and sweet and to the point. Quick question for you. Since I got my pal back here, what do you call a dog with no legs? Doesn't matter what you call him. He ain't gonna come to you anyways. Haha. Hope you enjoyed the rundown. See you later. You have a great day.